Yeah, well, I mean, you know, the guy likes dinosaurs, and, you know, I feel the dinosaur t-shirts are a little bit much.
He does remind me a bit of a T-Rex, you know, a bit of an animal. Yeah.
I don't like him. At all.
This is Conor O'Brien. Throughout his life, he's had a passion for dinosaurs. It's a passion that has often left him being an outcast. He currently studies history at university and is living in student accommodation.
Yeah, life's good. Life is really great. Only problem is, people keep telling me that I need to grow up and move on. But I just love dinosaurs. I just can't get enough of them. When I was younger, I tried becoming more like a dinosaur. So I ate dinosaur food like turkey dinosaurs, mushy peas, and boiled eggs. But problem is, my mum kept telling me that it wouldn't work. I was absolutely, absolutely devastated. Just gotta let Dan in.
Who's Dan?
Dan? Dan's my best mate. Best mate I could ever ask for. Come on, Dan. Oh, Dan, can you do my shoelaces? I can't reach.
Don't give me all that. You just don't know how. What happened to your Crocs, anyway?
I lost them on the bus. Oh, and while you're here, can you do me a favour? Can you go in the kitchen and make me some breakfast? I'm starving.
What do you want, baked beans?
Yeah.
Connor's best friend, Dan, lives fairly close to him and comes to make sure he's keeping well on a regular basis.
He's not a bad lad, really. It's just a pity he can't do things for himself a bit more. I mean, when he was younger, his mum's done a lot of stuff for him, hasn't she, so...
So you're looking after him whilst he's here?
Yeah, basically. That's all I seem to do. I have to cook, clean for him, tie his shoelaces, things like that. There you go.
Cheers.
You can't wear that for your interview now.
But I like it. Dad, you're tickling me. Oh. Right, I've put my CV, studying a history degree in university, and that I really like dinosaurs, and that I have 15 dinosaur toys, just in case it swings in my favour. I mean, who knows, they might want to put my toys on display. Actually, come to think of it, no. If they put it on display, I won't be able to play with my toys again, so no. Right, so anyway, the other day I bought this really big dinosaur.
Today is a very crucial point in Connor's life. This job means so much to him, and yet he fears that he'll fail to achieve his goals. In a few weeks' time. Until then, he has to play the waiting game.
Got this letter in the post today. I'm really, really nervous because it decides my fate whether I've got this job or not. So, fingers crossed. Job. I've got the bloody job. I'm actually really surprised I've got this job. I thought I wouldn't get it at all because in the middle of the interview I did a really eggy burp and I thought the chances of me getting this job are zero. But I'm just over the moon, I'm really happy.
What can you see for your future now?
Well, maybe sometime or later I'll get to work with dinosaur fossils. And who knows, maybe I'll meet a girl who loves dinosaurs as much as me.
Next time on The Big Picture, we meet Britain's biggest cat lover.
I just love cats!